Let's watch some crazy stuff, yo! Jeez, Rick, oh my god!
Two of the most well-renowned movies of all time came out in 1994, Satan Tango and Shawshank Redemption. In the first 8 minutes of Shawshank Redemption, we see a lot. The editing is rapid, splicing together two scenes happening at completely different times. We see our main character, drunk in his car, looking at a gun. Cut to a court scene, he's being convicted. Cut back to his wife, cheating on him, back and forth for 5 minutes. We learn our main character drunkenly killed his wife and the man she was cheating on him with. Also, he's going to be serving two lifetime sentences in prison. We meet the main character, we know his backstory, and we know where the movie is going, all in 5 minutes. It's a great opening, one that Bel-Tar, director of Satin Tango, would probably shit on. So, how does Satin Tango open? Cows. Satin Tango opens with a colossal and admittedly impressive 8 minute long take, focusing mainly on a group of cows walking. And I'm serious. This 8 minute long take of this absolutely disgusting, gross town sets the tone for the movie. For the next 7 hours, this is what you're going to be watching. It honestly is a perfect opening for what this movie is. A spectacle. It makes you feel uncomfortable, sad, interested, and honestly it just makes you want to take a shower. It makes you feel all that emotion just from some cows in 8 minutes. It's great. There's a reason why it's one of the highest rated movies in history. So, let's talk about this movie. Known as Bel-Tar's magnum opus, is infamous for its terrifying 7 hour runtime. No movie should be 7 hours. I hate even calling it a movie because it's the length of three. I've seen Satin Tango once, and I hopefully will never watch it again. It slowly follows the inhabitants of a small village in Hungary deal with the effects of the fall of communism. If it sounds too depressing for you, don't worry, there's a cat in it. We need to find this man some serious help, and I'm genuinely concerned for him and anyone. Like, what does his family think of this? Yeah, to summarize, this movie's a nightmare. It's 7 hours of scarce dialogue, little to no plot, all set in this hellish landscape. Why does anyone like this shit? Seriously, people love this movie. I guess it's kind of like why people love Schindler's List, or Come and See, or even Mysterious Skin. Movies like those, that are absolutely joyless and miserable experiences for the most part. Well, I think being able to invoke an emotion like fear or sadness in interesting ways, or ways that make people think and reflect on the topic, is really impressive. Sometimes people want to think about the media they consume. They find it much more rewarding and inevitably enjoyable to experience a visceral hellscape than something that's easily consumable. I love bumping Shake It Up 24/7, 365, but sometimes I want to lay down in bed and listen to Death Consciousness and just cry all night. So what's the experience of Satin Tango? You're stuck in this world for 7 hours and the movie succeeds in really making you feel all the misery all these townsfolk feel. The movie is about dealing with the downfall of communism. By the end of it, I genuinely feel like I've lived through a world war. How does the movie do this with basically no dialogue or real characters for a 7 hour movie? Well, it's slow. That's most of it. Probably my least favorite genre in all of filmmaking, but also the most interesting to me, is slow cinema. The name kind of explains itself. Using lots of long takes, slow cinema is known for being less plot-driven and more observational and contemplative. Satin Tango takes this concept and commits to it to an incredibly impressive level. Just for reference, the average amount of shots in a 2-hour movie is about 1,045. In the 7-hour movie, there are exactly 150. Slow cinema relies completely on audience immersion. Filmmakers want you to get sucked into this world. Long takes are perfect for this, usually forcing your attention onto the same subject for an extended period of time, forcing you to read much more into the themes, what's happening, and what's the point of this. It can show us how horrible the monotonous repetition of being a housewife with no ambition can be, or the dehumanizing repetition of the military, or how tiresome the world can be to someone who no longer wants to go on living. All these movies sacrifice dialogue and plot and use long takes and atmosphere to convey their messages. And this is exactly what Satin Tango does best. Uses long takes to keep you focused on this miserable mood for as long as possible. For about the first 2 hours. Maybe three if I'm in a good mood. Have I mentioned this movie is 7 hours long? At a certain point, I've been immersed, I understand the themes, I'm feeling what the characters feel, and we still have 4 more hours of the movie left. Correct me if I'm missing something, but there are no new revelations or wildly different themes in the second half of this movie. It is simply too long. It is a fatal flaw of the film, in my opinion, that I do not need to explain any further. You understand why a 7-hour movie is unbearable. I'm not sure if this is just Bellatar's vision, that the movie is so tiresome to the point where you understand how miserable the townsfolk felt, and then it hits you over the head again and said, no, it was even worse than this, and then hits you over the head again and again with the same message to the point where you really do feel like you're living in a starving town because this movie is so goddamn boring. Bella himself said he wanted the film to be viewed in one sitting in the theater, and the producers genuinely wouldn't let him do that, because no, they had to show it in 3 parts. I don't know. Is he just trying to be challenging? It reminds me of a modern art piece or something, just trying to go against the system, intentionally provoke anger, and completely reshape the way we look at movies. I don't know. It is a movie that I don't think I will ever stop thinking about. It really is worth a watch if you're willing to actually try and get into it. Most everyone seems to adore it. The long takes are truly astonishing when you think about the intricate planning required to make these scenes. The visuals are phenomenal, and no one gives a bad performance. It is really interesting. I guess my final verdict is that objectively it is a masterwork of art. But I hate it at the same time. But like, I guess that's what the point of the movie is? I'm not sure. It's conflicting. Maybe the tango was the friends we made along the way.